Hey all, welcome to Parker's Reefs. On today's episode, it's the day. My main tank is finally here. All right, welcome to Parker's Reefs. If you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. We go over a whole heap of reefing reviews, tank tours, shop crawls, things like that. And of course, the main event, which is the focus of this video, is the construction of my dream reef tank. This is something that I've been planning for multiple years now and scrimping and saving and plotting and scheming and doing everything I could to make this dream happen. And today is a huge milestone in the development of that reef tank because the glass box itself is here. And everyone knows a reef tank isn't much of a reef tank without the glass box. So I thought I'd take you through the little journey on getting the notification that the reef tank is in Australia, that it's ready for pickup, getting it here, getting it out of the van and truck and getting it inside my house and onto the tank. Now, it's obviously fairly difficult times with COVID-19 restrictions, so we were much shorter resource than I would really have liked. Normally with something like this, I'd put a message out on Facebook to all my reefing buddies and say, hey, my main display tank's here. Anyone and everyone that has an hour spare or a couple hours spare, come on over and lend a hand. Now, because of COVID-19 restrictions, that's not quite the way we could really run it this time. We had to go with much, much fewer resources. And as a result, I had to be all hands on deck helping lift the tank and was not able to get as much footage as I would have really have liked to get of me bringing this tank into the house. But I've popped together this little video anyway, and then at the end I'll give you some really close-up footage of this tank and just how beautiful it really is. So let's get on into it and I'll run you through the process. All right, so it all started here when I got a message from the Waterbox distributor in Australia saying the tank's ready for pickup and we'll send you a picture or a video. And the guys at the warehouse did a great job quickly opening up the box just to give it a visual inspection to make sure all was okay. They didn't want to see a glass box of shattered glass in there. Sorry, a wooden box of shattered glass. So they lifted the lid off to give it a quick check, make sure everything looked fine, in which it looked brilliant. So I went about putting the stand in place, making sure it was nice and level, because once I add all this weight to it and add some water in there, even though I've got adjustable feet, which I can then level the tank up, I wanted to make sure it was spot on. So I also had a couple of days to kill, so I went about making sure the tank was perfectly level, and then got in touch with my local fish shop, who was who I arranged this tank through. David DeerPark Aquarium has been absolutely instrumental the whole process with this tank, and he sent me a little teaser picture to say that the tank's getting loaded up and that he had an ETA of 5:30 p.m. and that it weighs 540 kilos and that that was pretty much bottoming out his van. And here's a bit of a close-up of the tank. That's not a small van, mind you. It's a large van, and that that box took up a good portion of it. Now, at that point in time, I thought I'd let my wife know that my wife, who's been wanting to paint the walls a different color, that she had a couple of hours to get the paint on the wall behind the tank before it's out of access forever. So she got to work on it. Good on her. Absolute champion my wife is, and we got that done. You can see I've got some 19 mil polystyrene, H grade polystyrene, which was supplied by Geelong Polystyrene, believe it or not. They were fantastic. They cut that to size, and then just using the T-slot, I put a couple of little tabs in there to make sure that the foam didn't move. Now, next thing you know, Dave's here, and we've got this tank. Looks like his van's giving birth, or passing a number two, I guess. We've got this gigantic tank, and not the number of resources we'd like to get it out of the van, but long story short, I got my weightlifting kit on, and here we are. Ignore the name. It's not a Riccali. It's Sam Parker, and I chalked up my hands, and nah, I'm obviously taking the piss here a little bit, but realistically, I won't name the people that came and gave a hand just because of the restrictions that we're under, but I had a very small number of people that were willing to give up their muscles and their backs to come and lift this tank up in the air and get it up on that frame, and I'm very, very appreciative of it, and like I said, I'm just a bit disappointed that I wasn't able to get footage of that just because the limited people we did have meant that every single person here had to be lifting that glass box because it is 540 kilos of weight, and I just wanted to use a little bit of my photoshopping skills. Now, As I said, haters will say it's fake, but believe it or not, the tank was lifted up onto the stand, and here it is in all its glory, looking absolutely incredible. And wait till we take the plastic coating, the poly, the foam wrap, and then the cling wrap, and there you can see this tank. It just looks unbelievable. And it's one of those things that you've planned and schemed and envisioned for so long, but it's hard to imagine how incredible it is. And you can see that beautiful Eurobrace there. And of course, you know, despite being completely knackered, couldn't help but take a couple of little selfies in front of the tank, looking pretty sweaty, sore and tired there. And then of course, my daughter and I had to stop for a couple of poses. I promise you, my daughter is not a crip. She's trying to do the love heart sign there. She's just a little bit off, and you can see I'm a pretty big boy, in case you didn't know, and I fit in this tank pretty comfortably. I promise I won't be staying in that tank forever. It's just the way... It's one of those things you have to do when you get a tank you can fit in. You have to take a selfie inside the tank. So we took a few selfies, and all's well, ends well. But let me put the photos away and grab the video camera out. I'll show you how the tank is sitting as of today. All right, so here we go. Let's have a look at the tank itself. And there it is. Let's close that door behind me. But it's kind of hard to get an idea of the actual presence of the size of this tank on camera or on screen. But it's gigantic. It's exactly as I envisioned, the height, the size, the stand. Obviously, we've got all the cabinetry to come yet, and we've got the incredible sump to come, but it just has such a presence about it, and the fit and finish on it is just unbelievable. I mean, obviously, there's no water in the tank yet, but if we have a look through, that's looking through 19 mil panel here and a 19 mil panel there. And obviously we got no glass there, 38 mil of glass on the diagonal there. And you can't tell, this glass is just unbelievably beautiful. The edges, I mean, that's a full 19 mil thick, beautiful silicon work. You can just see up in there, the little laser edge. I'm not sure how well we're gonna get that on camera because it's quite small. It's a very fine little detail. I'll see if I can get it to focus. There we go. Parker's Reef, framed in Waterbox. Nice little customization there, just to show that this is a Waterbox tank. And you can see why they would want to claim it as a Waterbox tank, because it is incredible. Check out this unbelievable one-piece Euro brace on top. It's just so, so nice. One piece all the way around, no braces down the middle. Beautiful rounded edges. We've even got these little where they've machined or laser cut or water cut, whatever they've done, the edging on that is just beautiful. And then of course we've got the two holes that have been drilled for the shadow V2 overflow, and then in each corner we've got the holes for the return lines. Again, beautifully done. Now this piece on the back here, that's black tinted glass with a black paint on the back as well, so it gives this real sense of depth, because the glass is black in itself, but then we've also got a black back, so it just creates this depth, which is kind of hard to see in the morning with all the reflections there, but you can see myself in the reflection, but it just really gives it such a presence. Now have a look at the base down here. We've got incredibly thick, this is twin 19 mil base on it, absolutely gigantic. So anyway, I'm not sure what else I can show you on the tank. We've got, the Euro brace itself is 19 mil as well. Serious bit of kit. This tank was 540 kilos. A heck of a job to lift up, especially 1.1 meters in the air. as you can probably tell by my voice, I'm super excited at the moment. It's just, it's really taking shape. This is something I've worked at, saved on, planned for so long, and now it's really starting to take shape. So, thank you to all my viewers that have watched this come this far. Huge, huge thank you to my channel sponsors that get behind Parker's Reef and just make some of these things possible. And of course, a massive, massive thank you to my channel supporters. I've got a loyal following of a good couple dozen followers and fans that contribute to this channel as well, which just goes a long, long way. So huge shout out to you guys. I'm really looking forward to bringing you a bit more footage and content on the next steps in setting this tank up. But in fact, I'll just pan back here so you can get a good look. That's a 75-inch TV. That's the stand there. This is about, actually, I'll sit down on the couch. This is where I sit. I can keep an eye down there. You can see my subscriber numbers, 7,450. Have a look at this 75-inch TV watching the Lakers or the Collingwood Magpies on AFL football. Then I'll pan across there and just have a look at this gigantic reef tank. Sensational. Now, just before I wrap up, I want to give a quick reminder for those of you who have not subscribed as yet. Please consider doing so. It doesn't cost you anything. There's a little box you can tick just down in the bottom corner there, which will allow you to subscribe. Hit the bell notification as well, and it'll give you updates every time I release a video. And as you can tell now by the fact that the tank is actually here, stands there, sump's not far away. I've actually got the substrate in the other room ready to put in. The rockscape's not too far away. Obviously, over the next couple of months, we're going to see a lot of updates on this tank, and it's stuff that's not to be it's not to be missed, because I haven't really spared much expense, planning, or effort, or anything on this build. I've done everything within my physical means to make this my absolute dream tank. So, if you're interested in the journey, please consider subscribing, and you'll be able to see all the videos as we go. But other than that, guys, I might sign out. I've got a lot of work to do in getting this tank from being a glass box of air to a dream reef tank. So I'm going to get cracking into it. Thank you for watching, and till next time, guys, stay safe and keep reefing. Cheers. Bye.